Right, I've had a few requests to do a follow-up video on the MSK in comparisons with hatchets. The nearest thing we've got with a hatchet is a small-handed axe, but we can predict where it's going to be in between a cold steel trail fork. So we'll have a bit of a chopping test with this MSK. And I'm just able to say that where it replaces a hatchet, this one with a new edge is probably one of the best MSKs going out there. So we're going to have a bit of a chop test with this MSK and some nominal choppy hatchet sort of tools. Right, so the light door 2x2. So 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. Start right at the bottom, do a mini sold. I've given them a 2 minutes of work putting an edge on them. So even that, when it comes to chopping, outperforms it. I'll do it across the grain, just for a bit of fun. Sock. That's the MSK. Okay. Cheap and cheerful. 40 quid, you got it. Cold steel. Again, I spent about 2 minutes putting an edge on it. Incomparable, really. Incomparable.
Double the duty.
Control. So that cut was the MSK, and that cut is the trail hawk. Cross grain. Pretty good. So deep I can actually hang on to it. Oh, hi. With a reprofiled edge, it's good. It's pretty good at chopping a long grain. But that already outperforms it in terms of where you leave your hatchet at home with an MSK. It will do a job, but it doesn't really get an inner bulk part of it. But that's for the guys. The actual edge that I've put on there. So, the owner of this knife has a cracker, right? So as MSKs go, this one performs really well. But for all the hype out there, it doesn't really quite hold us on against even a small hatchet tomahawk. It's got 4.6 blades out.